This is consistent with them, not 24 strikes new, although I'll look a little bit different. It's just the, it's what's necessary for you to get rid of the, this bill determines what size of information the procedure puts up. A 14-year-old rape victim, the married couple, it's from a single 40-year-old woman, the 18-year-old in college on scholarship, the physically ill, the academic. And so we reduced to that was those complex decisions in the statutory form. But of course, no case, given the all of the 8 million in black and white statutory box, reproductive decisions take place in the messy gray zone of our choices. Informed by individual circumstances and conscience. In the end, those conscience are drafted in a bill that sets forth their view of the law as they would like it to see, not the law it takes to live. The state legislators are sworn to uphold the Constitution. That is unacceptable.
So I feel like this is unfair to them, and it's unsafe for them. It's based on what you live with, and how they treat people. And I think there are surely reasonable ways that you could have provided to talk to some of the same rules and needs for the region if you can afford or give them to you. You don't have to come out. I understand we have power and we have control. I don't think this is going to be a big mistake. It's not about mission. It's not about abortion. This is not about women. It's about women. And we know this because in this issue, clearly granted the heart of those desires to change or to curtail abortion or to make sure that women would do it without. We would be working hard on the other end of the spectrum to meet our needs. We would be working hard to make sure that every woman in childbearing years, regardless of age, childbearing years, as free and easy as it comes from men is urged to use it no matter what. But we don't do that. We don't have this spectrum. Making sure that people do not have unintended pregnancy. We talk about it at the end of the line rather than the beginning of the line, and there is nothing in this discussion. Plus, I agree to this basis. We need to draw two conclusions that the bill sponsors conflate. One, we're really stupid. But two, women like more guns.
I will grant to those who know me, many of you don't, and to those who do, that you don't really think that I think women are stupid or immoral. In fact, my motive behind this bill has to do with the fact that I think women are very intelligent and very moral, but they are not always informed. I can't tell you the things that I thought I knew going into delivery, that afterward I said, you didn't tell me that. And he said, yes, we did, but I didn't remember it. This is about making sure that women know what they need to know before they do a very serious decision. I'm not downplaying it. I'm not implying that somehow or another she flippantly makes this decision. I'm recognizing the seriousness of it and her need to have that information and to have it ahead of time.